All right, let's start the lesson today. Today we have topic English-speaking countries. Why are they worth visiting? Maybe you know something about English-speaking countries. However, today we will not talk about Great Britain. We will not talk about US, but some other countries. And the countries you have on your pieces of paper. So turn now. And this is the plan of our lesson. This is the plan of our lesson, and this is the goal. So I want you, everybody, to know how we can encourage people to see English-speaking countries, to say what we can see there, what we can do there, and what is interesting about these countries you have. Well, this is our goal. It is in Polish here, so you can have a look if you need. So do we know the goal? What is it? Jaki mamy cel? No. Co musicie umieć? Przedstawić? Kraje anglojęzyczne. Dobra. Czy to obojętnie, które kraje będą?
Nie.
To będą te kraje, które macie? Tak jest. Dobra. To jest nasz cel. No dobra. To czy wiemy, czego się mamy nauczyć na lekcji? Czego? Opowiadać o krajach anglojęzycznych. Super. All right, let's go on. To be successful, we have to complete few steps. Żebyśmy doszli do celu, musimy parę kroków sobie zrealizować. And we will do that one by one. So the first one is reading the text. You have the text. You can have a look now. You have there the country, you have there the text. We will read the text. You have also there the part where you have to create questions. Three questions about the text you will read. But this is not all. I want you also to find three reasons, at least, why we should visit the country you have. So if you have Australia, you have to find three reasons why we should go there. If you have New Zealand, we should find three reasons why we should go there. And when you have Ireland, the same. Easy?
Yes.
Okay, so co musimy zrobić?
Napisać trzy pytania i trzy fakty, dlaczego trzeba odwiedzić Australię.
Dobra, dlaczego można odwiedzić Australię? I każdy ma swój kraj i tak samo robi. Wiemy, co robimy? All right, so this is the first step, but not, don't start yet. Then we'll go to step number two. In step number three, we will have to talk about our text. So we will change the groups, and you will talk about your country with your new partners. This is a challenge, but you can do it. All right, but this is not all. You also have to ask them the questions you will prepare together in your first group. And then the people who will listen to you have to answer. In Polish? All right. To pierwsze, co robimy? Mam opowiedzieć i... Zadać pytania i reszta na nie
odpowiada.
Super. This is of course not all. We have number four to do. Number four is you have to find in your worksheets the place to write another three reasons to visit the country your friends will be talking about. Okay? Czyli coś tu musimy zrobić?
Opisać trzy fakty z innych krajów.
No super, Vicky, dobra. Wszyscy wiedzą, co zrobić? All right. And then we have the next step. The next step is here. W oparciu o własny tekst informacji uzyskane od pozostałych uczniów potrafi odpowiedzieć na postawione pytania. Omówiliśmy, prawda? I wymienić co najmniej trzy powody, dla których warto odwiedzić nasze kraje. My się skupiamy na tych, tak? O, musimy cofnąć. I jeszcze mamy jeden krok do zrobienia. The next step is, which is the goal actually, I want you to talk in pairs about these English-speaking countries and present at least 10 sentences, here you have 10 sentences, about these English-speaking countries all together and give the reasons. Yes? All right, so now tell your partners what you have to do. To teraz w parach mówimy, co mamy zrobić. You can speak in Polish if you want. You can speak Polish if you want.
Okay. So I have to read these articles, later my question together, and compete for reasons to visit these countries. And facts about them.
Czy albo jednej informacji, która jest ciekawa dla tego tekstu?
Have you got any questions? Is everything clear? All right, so the final thing is here. We will have a quiz, and we will try to solve the quiz in groups. If you want, you can do that separately as well. And there I prepared for you questions about all the countries you have, and you will answer. All right, so let's start. Let's start. This is the first step. So get ready with the texts. You have around 10, 15 minutes. We will see how much we need. At least 10 minutes to read the text, to find the questions, and to find the reasons. You can consult in group. If you want, you can ask me. You can ask your friends about the vocabulary. And if you really need, you can also use your mobile phones. Okay? So, ready, steady, go. When you're ready, then you can start creating the questions together. And don't wait for the others. When you're ready, you can start.
Are there in Australia place who likes diving?
So maybe you can ask what can we see there.
Landscape.
Yeah,
you can ask, like, if you're a nature lover, what can you see there? Question.
Okay,
yeah.
So.
If you have any questions, ask away. Don't be afraid.
What can you see there?
So famous. Good word. Why is the Great Barrier Reef so famous in the world?
Okay.
Ireland's passage graves are a few hundred years older than the pyramids.
But I
used the first sentence I would put here.
And something more, maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe we can.
They had risen up. They had risen up 1,000 years before. So we would change the first sentence into something different, but in the same meaning.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So?
All right, that's a very good question.
Okay,
it's a not a natural lover, but nature lover.
Oh, okay.
Okay, nature lover.
Uh-huh.
All right, at E here.
What?
E, like email.
Uh-huh.
This is E, uh-huh. It is here. All right, now it's correct.
Na przykład ten Iron Passage Graves, które są starsze od piramid.
Aha, dobra, okej.
Rozumiecie?
Yes. So,
Ireland.
Ireland.
To.
To.
Have so many large prehistoric monuments. And for example, they are passages graves.
No. I że są starsze od piramid.
Which are
so
older.
Ireland. Ireland has no. Okay. Has very.
Może a lot of.
Oh, yes. All right, this is a question. So, what can we visit in Sydney, right? Mm-hmm. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Remember about the reasons. You can complete them later, but don't forget. Oh, I see that she had the idea for the second question.
Yes.
What kind of music usually play in Australia, Ireland?
Music usually play, but who?
It's usually.
What kind of music do they usually play? Yeah? We need a person.
Ah, okay.
What kind of music do they? Yeah. All right.
Do.
Mm. You have a question, so you need to.
Mm.
So the reason is that
wherever you go,
you can hear traditional music.
Any ideas? Do you need help? No. He's going to eat me.
So maybe one reason it's kind of this.
Mm-hmm. Good question for that.
From this to this soul sentence, two reasons.
Entertainment places? Or nightlife? If you talk about some pubs or discos?
A lot of?
A lot of our time in Sydney.
Ready with the second?
What and how? Curious.
Who and how? Okay, now I understand it. Okay, that's a good question.
They can't, na przykład, że fakt to they can't spend their time at pubs without
live music, tak, and
without
animals. Without.
They can't
spend time
at sea.
They can spend time without live music.
In pubs.
Czemu without?
No bo they can't.
Are 3 minutes okay?
Yeah, okay.
Or do you need more time? 3 minutes?
Yes.
Can
do time. Spaces.
Mm-hmm. They are very friendly and welcoming.
Okay, almost ready. Okay, so now you can read the questions and read the reasons again. If you have to add something, add it, and we'll be ready in a few minutes. Almost. Okay.
Myślicie, że zrozumieją, what is a total must?
Have you got everything?
Last one.
The last one, all right.
In Ulu, you can notice very breathtaking.
Landscape.
Okay.
Is this group ready?
Yes.
This group?
No.
You have to answer. Okay. So we wait. How about you?
What? Adventures.
1 minute.
Can you do that?
Mm-hmm. So we can get ready for speaking.
You can.
All right.
There are.
And they will divide you into groups now.
So you
have to be ready for walking a bit.
And the reason would be here you can jumping, parachuting, and.
Okay, so you're ready, and you. Okay. Well, you're finishing, so we have to check whether we have everything. Aha! Okay. Well, the first thing, did you read?
Yes.
Did you understand?
Yes.
Most. Okay. Did you ask questions? Oh, did you create the questions? Yeah. Have you got the reasons?
Yes.
Now, do you know your colors?
Yes.
Yeah. All right. So here we have the sunny yellow. So if you have yellow color, come here. Here we have time for a place for blue. Here we have place for orange. And the people who have pink. This is the special table for you. All right. Have we completed the first task? So we are step forward to our goal, which is to be able to speak about English-speaking countries. That's right. Let's go to number two. So now, I want you to talk about your country, ask the questions. The other people have to note the reasons. If you have some questions, you can ask. You can check the spelling if you need. And for that, you have more or less 3 minutes per person. If we need more time, we will wait for you. If you don't need so much time, then you can go to next person. Okay? So ready? The first person. Choose the first person to speak. And let's go.
In Australia, is the Great Barrier Reef is famous because it's a great area.
Do you know what to do?
In world,
we okay,
can
so
see
first.
All right. Life.
So you take notes. If you have to ask about something, ask her.
Animals,
she's there for you. She's the specialist now.
And fish, beautiful. Two. It's Sydney. We can spend.
If you want to know how to write something, you can ask him. Robert can show you if you need.
Culture.
Can you show them? Can you show them how to read that? How to write that?
Surf.
Yeah. Okay.
Glaciers. Glaciers. And pastures.
Eight kilometers.
If you have some questions, you can ask
her. Can you repeat?
If you don't know how to write it, you can ask her. He can show you.
Ru is a gigant round rock covering 8 kilometers, and we see very beautiful views. And that's all.
And no questions, yeah?
Yes. Why is the Great Barrier Reef famous in the world?
Because you can see a lot of animals, marine life, sharks, beautiful fish. And that's all?
Yeah.
Okay.
Monuments in Ireland. Which one is older, Ireland Passage Graves or pyramids in Giza?
Ireland Passage Graves.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Okay, and the last one is blue. It's a brown block for the migrators. And what is interesting? You can notice a very rare issue because the islands in the rock produce energy when and for the sunrise and sunset. So, and it is a good very rare thing.
Are older. Then the pyramid at Giza. For example, is that the passage grows okay. The reason number two is wherever you go, you can hear a traditional music.
They are very friendly and welcoming. In New Zealand, you can tramping, parachuting, try the bungee jump, and do a lot of things.
Okay.
Questions? Yeah. So, if you are a natural lover, what can you see there?
Beautiful landscapes.
Yeah, pastures. Beautiful views. Volcanoes?
Yes. Who and how are Kiwis like?
Which are friendly
and welcome.
Okay.
In New Zealand, we have got other adventures, and this is and you can there tramping, parachuting, surfing, and cycling.
We can go.
Cycling, surfing, parachuting, and what else?
Tramping? No questions. If you are a natural lover, what can you see there?
You can see beautiful landscapes.
That's yours. Nice.
What? You can check some words, but try to make your own nose.
Ireland's.
Yes, Ireland's specific graves. What kind of music do they usually play in Ireland?
Traditional
yes.
music.
Yes. And what is a total must in Irish pubs?
Gin.
Yes.
live music.
Yes. And that's all.
Now you can check your notes, and after a moment we'll go to the next step. If you have some questions, ask away, don't worry. Almost ready? that you shouldn't revise, you should take your own notes.
What's Kega?
Not the students.
Because there is about dance of marine life.
Laura, you should be speaking. I'm asking questions.
We can spend lots of time in Sydney. There are opera, parks, restaurants, delicious food and surfing.
Yeah. Have you talked about that?
Yeah.
All right. And is it everybody?
Yeah.
Yes, okay. We are ready, they are ready. Okay. How much time do you need? 1 minute. How much time do you need? Oh, finish. All right. So we'll wait for you. You can again look at your notes. If you have some questions, ask again. And we'll go to the next step. Now, Laura, you'll be speaking together with Marta in a moment, and Natalia, you'll be speaking with Kate in a moment, okay? And Vicky, you will turn to Zuzia. Are we ready for the last
from the beginning?
Paula, is your group ready?
Almost.
Almost. But should we wait?
Yeah, like half a minute.
All right.
Okay.
When I eat is survives and. Service, the iron, if a rock produces, okay.
Okay, other questions.
Okay, why is the Great Barrier Reef so famous in the world?
Because it has, there is abundance of life, wildlife,
in
yeah, the water.
Yes. What can we visit in Sydney?
We can visit opera, restaurants, delicious food, and surfing. We can go surfing.
Okay.
Yeah, we are ready.
Okay. If you're ready, now we have to look again here whether we know everything we should. Woo. All right. Well, let's... too far. Okay, so have you talked about your country?
Yes.
Okay, questions?
Yes.
Done. Answers and notes?
Yes.
Done. Okay, so we are one step forward and we go to the next part. Now, we have to find new parts. You are together? Kate, you are together with Natalia. And Vicky, you are together with Zuzia. What I want you is to now present our main goal. So I want you to talk more or less 10 sentences. If you can speak longer, I know you can, but try to limit it a little bit so that everybody can say something. And you present the reasons to visit English-speaking countries. So the question is, why are English-speaking countries worth visiting? And give reasons. So one person speaks, then the other person speaks, and let's go. Yes, you can talk about all the countries. You don't have to focus on one only.
To może po polsku ogarniemy to tak. English, że kraje anglojęzyczne są bardzo ciekawe i różnorodne. I teraz wymienimy w stylu, że na przykład w Australii to, w Nowej Zelandii to, w Irlandii to.
But you can speak. You don't have to write.
Okay.
Yeah, speaking. Text moving on. All right. You have already some notes. That would be your homework, if you want.
The Great Barrier Reef and
Alcatraz, the Seven. You don't have to write, you have to speak.
Or
so say something, okay. You have text moving. To just present what you think. Yes, mm-hmm. The reasons you like the most, or you remember the most.
In Ireland, we can see Ireland has graves, which are older than the pyramids. Another thing we can know is Ireland, for example, going to Irish pubs, where we can listen to traditional music, live music, and also we can drink some
traditional music.
Okay. So Irish in contrast, overall, is Arab worth visiting because there are a lot of amazing and breathtaking sceneries.
I think we should visit
a lot of things, like homes, even
because
so we have everything
Sydney
there.
Is very famous.
City? It's a capital.
Yeah.
Most from these three. Where would you like to go?
Why?
There are
parks with live music, and traditional music.
Everywhere.
Yes, and you?
I would like to go to Australia because I would love to see
the famous Sydney Opera and all.
How is it going? How is it finishing? Well, have a look again here. So, can we really answer the question now?
Yes.
And next time we have a short test. Can you write it?
Yes.
Yes. Everybody gets the best marks, yeah?
Yes.
Sure. All right. Is it done?
Yes.
Let's check it. I have to believe you. Well, we can do that, I heard. But how about a quiz? So now, let's connect with Kahoot. And I have some questions for you. Try to answer in groups. If you want, you can use your own mobile. You can use one for the group, as you prefer. And we'll check your knowledge. So let's go. Yes, when you within your group, or if you want, you can do that individually. That's up to you. Yes, just like, actually you can. Yes, you can. Uh-huh. That'd be really good if you sit in the groups you were working or while speaking, because everybody has got a different country, and then we can compare our knowledge. Yeah? Oh, no. No, sorry. We have to go to the first groups. Yeah, the first three groups. Oh, my mistake. Yeah, that would be senseless. All right, so let's go back. All right. And now we need to connect. True. Okay, so take your mobile phones. And here we have the pin. We got at least one phone per group? Yes, here we have it. And here, yeah, all right. You can dance a little bit if you want. All right, one person's in, two more. Okay, and three, all right. Is it everybody? No? We have some individual players as well, right? Okay. And ready? So, okay, everybody now. So I have some questions, try to answer to them. We have few minutes. Oh, you're fast, all right. Not all the questions are so easy. Okay. You know really everything, do you? True, it is true. Okay. That's New Zealand. Mm-hmm. That's Australia. Let's try one more question. We have some winners. Okay, that's Great Barrier Reef and Paradise for Divers. Actually, in Sydney we also have water, so partly it is true. Okay, and now the final question. Still, you can have 1,000 points. Difficult question. All right. Now, the winner is Paul Chen Zuska. Congratulations. And good orange, the second place. Bravo. Mana. All right. And the others are not so bad. Girls, almost. Okay, so thank you very much for today's lesson. I hope you will remember everything for the next lessons and for Matura exam. And the final question. Po co nam potrzebna ta wiedza o krajach anglojęzycznych?
Czy byśmy chcieli kiedyś tam pojechać?
No na przykład, po co jeszcze? Jakbyśmy chcieli pojechać. No a jak oglądacie czasami film, jak tam mówią, że kiwi, kiwi, to co?
To już wiem, co to jest.
Przynajmniej wiem, co to jest, dobra. Okay, so thank you very much and see you next lesson.